Hey guys, this is Subhashish Mishra, your test coach. Today I will share the ESTAT interview questions which are asked in Cognizant. I'll also share the overall interview experience. So if you're going for an ESTAT role interview, it will be very helpful for you. The interview was mainly for 1 to 6 years of experience candidates, and the skills like functional testing, API testing, Java, Selenium, SQL, Agile, Jira and all. I have collected these questions from multiple people. So if you are preparing for interviews, please go through these questions and prepare for that. I'm sure this will help you to crack the interview in a short time. Here I will not explain the answers, as I have covered most of the interview questions and answers in my previous videos. I'll give you the playlist link in the video description. Okay, so here you can see the playlist where I have covered most of the ESTAT QA testing interview questions. See here, top 20 Java interview questions, 10 API testing interview questions, REST assured API automation interview questions, Selenium interview questions. So go through all these questions, okay? So you will find answers also here. So I'm not explaining the answers here in these interview questions, okay? So if you like my videos, please like, share and subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so you will not miss any further notification. Okay, so let's start. If you are going to Cognizant for an interview for a ESTAT role, there will be 3 rounds of interviews. But sometimes it may be 2 or 4, depending on the specific requirement. But the standard one is 3 rounds. First rounds are pure technical rounds based on Java, Selenium, SQL, API testing, testing concepts, right? So the second round will be a technical managerial round. Okay, again, you will face technical questions, but you can say it is more of technical managerial round. You will find maybe some managerial questions, some technical questions. And if you are going to work for a client, in that case, you may face one client round. So basically that will be a technical round again. So in that case, you may face 4 rounds of interview. Otherwise, it will be 3 rounds. And the final round is the HR round. Nowadays, you know, most of the interviews are happening virtually after COVID. So you will face video call rounds through Cognizant digital interview app. It will be very smooth. You will get all the details from HR, how to connect for that interview. So don't worry much. One more thing I would like to add here from my personal experience. Whenever you are giving an interview through video call and answering the queries, try to look at the camera. That gives a sense of eye contact with the interviewer and builds a lot more confidence. Okay, so now let's see what are the questions you get in the first technical round. Okay, so most of the questions are again based on Java, Selenium, your manual testing. Okay, so let's see. So the very first thing is the self introduction and role and responsibility. So in every interview you will face this, because without introduction how you will start one interview, right? And interviewer also want to understand what exactly your role and what exactly you are doing in your current project and all. So the first question always starts with introduction and maybe a role and responsibility, right? Let's go to the next one. So what are the different locators in Selenium? So you see, the very first question is from Selenium and is from locators, because this is the very basic question, right? How you will able to identify any web element, right? Then write XPath for few elements. How you will able to write some XPath, right? You should know how to write XPath and all. So they will give you some web elements. For that, you need to write XPath. Then the next question is, what is desired capabilities in Selenium? Again, very important question. What is desired capabilities in Selenium? What exceptions you get if there is no element when you use find element and find elements? Okay, again, this is also very tricky and important question. This I have covered in my interview questions. You can check it, right? So what is the exception? How do you handle window pop-ups? Very important question. You may have to write the code for that also, right? Some people will give you to write the code, how you handle window pop-ups. What is the difference between page factory and page object? Okay, again, when you are telling you are using some framework, or what kind of framework it is, what is page object model, what is page factory, you will get questions around that. How to delete cookies? Again, this is also one important question. How you will manage, you will delete cookies, right? Next question, you have a link to the main window. When you click on that link, it opens three new windows. One of the window consists of an iframe. How you will navigate there? So basically this question is on iframe. How you are handling iframe in Selenium? So let's see the next question. There are 5 tabs on the homepage of a website. You need to navigate to each tab and verify the page is loaded. Write optimal logic. So they just want to see how you are writing the logic. These are the basic code, right? Basic code you should write. You should able to write using Selenium. So they just want to see what is your approach, how you are writing it. Now let's see the next question. Explain the architecture of your framework and why that approach was taken instead of others. See, very important question. From framework, what is the exact framework you are using in your project? You should able to explain it. What is the flow, right? So you should able to explain your framework. You will definitely get one question from framework in any Selenium interview question, right? So you should able to explain that, and what exactly, why you have taken that approach, why not something else, right? That question also you may get, right? So let's go to the next question. What is a test plan? Okay, so this is again a fundamental testing concept, right? What is a test plan? What is a test strategy? What is a test case? You can get this kind of questions also. What's your thought? We need to invest time in test plan and test case, or we should directly execute tests? So they just want to know your mindset. So you want to spend some time in the documentation, or you are just interested to execute the test. So what is your thought in that, right? Tricky question. You have to answer in a proper way. When do you think your testing is completed, right? Again, a tricky question on manual testing, I can say, right? So just understand the fundamentals, right? Understand the testing concepts. When we stop testing, right? So let's go to the next one. What is the final keyword? Very basic question from Java. What is the final keyword? What is the difference between interface and abstract class? And when to use what? Okay, so you need to find out the difference between interface and abstract class, and again you have to tell when you should use interface, when you should use abstract class. What is the difference between this and super keyword? Very important question, right? Even very fundamental question. What is the difference between this and super keyword? Why ArrayList instead of an array, right? So what is the basic difference between ArrayList and array, I can say, right? Why to use ArrayList, why not array? So that is what the fundamental questions you can see here, all the fundamental questions. What is a singleton class, right? Some design pattern questions. What is a singleton class? Write a program to print the duplicate characters in a string. A very simple program, find duplicate characters in a string. And the next one is write code to read data from Excel. So whenever you are using some Selenium framework, you should have written this code, right? How to read or write data from Excel sheet, right? So find the answer for all these questions and practice that. It's not like that you will face these questions only in Cognizant. You may face these questions in some other companies also. These are very basic fundamental questions, okay? So let's move to the next round, that is technical round. So however, I've told, generally the second technical will be technical manager round, okay? So let's see what are the questions in the technical manager round. So again, the very first thing is the introduction, and let's see the second question. Why are you looking for a change? Very important question. So you should have a very honest answer which will convince the interviewer. Why are you looking for a change? Right? So figure out the reason. Why are you looking for a change? Just don't give some silly reason. That will not convince the interviewer. Just try to give a proper reason which will convince the interviewer. Tell some negative test cases for Facebook login page. Right? So see here the manual testing part, right? Whenever you are doing some functional testing, whether you are only driving the positive test cases or you are writing negative test cases also. So that's what here they are asking. Tell some negative test cases for Facebook login page. So try to tell as many test cases you can, right? So think about it. Let's see the next question. If developer is not able to reproduce your issue and marked it invalid, what will you do? Again, the very real-time question. It happens. We raised one issue which is not reproducible by the developer. So what is the next things we can do? How we will convince the developer that this issue is valid, right? So these things happens in our real-time industry, right? So in our day-to-day life, it happens. So how you are dealing with that, right? Let's see the next question. If there are 1,000 test cases to automate, what is your approach, right? So maybe you will have less time or you will have some other priority work. How you are managing that? If you have 1,000 test cases to automate, so 1,000 is again a big number, right? So how you will deal with that? What is your approach, right? So basically they just want to understand what are the different thought process you have, how you are going to deal with this kind of situation, right? As I told, this is a technical managerial round. So let's see the next question. What are the defects you have found while automating your application, right? Again, very tricky question. So whenever you are writing so much of automation, so definitely you would have seen some defects. Otherwise, what is the use of your automation, right? You are writing so many automation test cases and you are not finding the bugs. Even while automating, you are seeing, you are going through the application, in that time also you can get some defects. So what are the defects you have found, right? Let's see the next question. How do you execute test in priority wise? Again, whenever you are automating so many test cases, you should execute in a priority. So how you do that? So test and jury related questions, right? What is the difference between assert and verify? Very fundamental question, right? So go and figure it out. What is the difference between assert and verify? I have explained all these questions in my interview question series, right? So you can go through that. What is API? So whenever we tell that we know API testing, the very first question comes, what is API? How you cover end-to-end API testing? Again, it is a very basic question. What is your approach? How you cover, how you do end-to-end API testing? Difference between REST and SOAP. Very, very important, I can say. You should know what is the difference between REST and SOAP. I have explained all these things in our previous videos. Just go and watch those videos. You will find all these answers if you don't know. If you know, it is well and good. Let's see the next question. How will you validate dynamic response for an API? It is a very important question in API testing. How will you validate dynamic response for an API? For example, in your API response, some ID is getting generated. Some random ID is getting generated. How will you validate that? Or if it is a very big response, which is generating dynamically, always it is keep on changing, how you will validate that? So you should write some code for that, or what is your approach? Maybe you need to explain that. What are the serialization and deserialization? So again, concepts in API testing, right? Why the main method is static? So very fundamental questions in Java. Why the main method is static? Can we write only concrete methods in abstract class? Again, fundamental questions, right? Can we have a constructor in abstract class? Very basic questions, fundamental questions. Do we know Git workflow and explain it? So if you know Git workflow, what are the commands you are using, how you are doing Git push, right? Or how you are doing a pull, how you are doing a commit. So you need to explain all those things. What is Jenkins and how to set up it? So if you would have told, like, you know CI, you know CD, so definitely you will get questions on this. What is Jenkins? how to set up it and what is the advantage of it, what you will get out of it, right? So how it will be helpful in your project. So then there are some SQL queries to join two tables and find maximum salary for a lady employee. So basically you have to join some tables and you need to find some maximum salary. Okay, so maybe you have to use multiple combinations here, right? You have to join a table, you have to use where clause, right? So all those things you need to do here. What is a sprint? See, the questions related to Agile. What is a sprint? What is a retrospective meeting? So you are getting questions around all, like Selenium, Java, TestNG, Agile, right? SQL. So questions around all. So that's all about your technical rounds in your both first technical round and second technical managerial round. Now let's see the HR round questions. Again, I will say HR rounds are very normal discussion. Okay, don't worry much about the HR round. You will get simple questions. Just be honest and answer with honesty. Okay, so let's see the questions. Why do you consider yourself a suitable candidate for this position? Okay, so basically why they will hire you, right? Or why you are the best fit for this position? Why do you want to leave your present job or company? Why you want to switch, right? Basically that question. What is your strength and weakness? So try to figure it out, the best answer for you. Okay, it will vary for each individual. Okay, but still try to figure it out. What is your strength and what is your weakness? Okay, then some salary negotiation and joining date related queries. Okay, and basically I will say it is not much complicated, normal discussions will be there. And if you have done good in your technical rounds, this will be just a normal discussion. That's all. I hope these questions will give some idea what kind of questions are asked in Cognizant. You may not get exact these questions, but you can expect similar pattern questions. Even similar questions can be asked in different interview, like in different companies. Okay, so understand the concept, make sure your fundamentals are clear. If you are interested to learn more these concepts, you can always refer to my tutorial videos. Okay, so here is my channel. Okay, I have lot of videos, like I have Cypress Web Automation, I have Selenium step-by-step complete tutorial, then manual testing concepts, okay, frequently asked Java programs. So lot of playlists are there, you can go through all these things, API testing tutorial, okay, using Postman and REST Assure, TestNG. So everything is there, you can go through all these tutorial links. Okay, I will give all these links in the video description, so don't worry. Okay, even you can go through this one if you are preparing for the interview, right? You just go through this SDET QA testing interview questions and answers. You will get lot more questions here, questions and answers. Okay, Java, API testing, Selenium, SQL, Unix, puzzles, protractor, manual testing questions. So lot more, even some fundamental questions like test case design techniques. Okay, test cases for Facebook login page, test cases for pain. So you will get lot more questions, top 15 agile testing interview questions. Okay, defect lifecycle, lot of questions and answers you will get it here. Okay, all the best for your interview. Please comment and let me know if it is helpful for you. Also let me know out of these questions, how many you got in your interview and what are the new questions you are asked. Thank you. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comment section. I'll try to explain it. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel.